In today's episode, let's check out Aurashikha Agarbatti's Tuberose Incense. Namaste everyone and welcome to Om Incense Show with DJ, a show that helps you increase your incense quotient. So if you are an incense enthusiast, consider subscribing. In these kind of episodes, we first check out the packaging and fragrance of the incense, then we talk a little about the incense world, and we wrap up the episode with a quiz, so you might want to stay here till the end. So today we have Aurashikha Agarbatti's Tuberose Incense, which is packed in a very simple pack. It's a normal thick pack, thick papered pack. It's just a normal regular rectangular pack, and it's all in yellow with a gray marbling on it, so if you can see that. And it has a simple Aurashikha logo here, which is a registered logo, so if you can see the R there in circle, Aurashikha Agarbatti's, and it says Tuberose Incense. Then on the back side, what we have is a simple, it's a barcode, and then they say Tuberose Marbling 10 gram. MRP is 38 inclusive of taxes. Contents is 10 gram, and then they say this incense is made with ingredients as per the guidelines of the International Fragrance Association, Geneva, Switzerland. And then they say burn in a well-ventilated room, and then they say handmade by Aurashikha Agarbatti's Sri Aurobindo Ashram, Pondicherry. So that's what it has. And if you remember, I told you earlier that, you know, this incense, and there are very many other incenses that I got from Aurashikha Agarbatti's from Aurobindo Ashram. And we have an ashram here, the Aurobindo Ashram branch here in South Delhi in Sarvodaya Enclave. And there's a bookstore called Shabda inside that campus. So they have all the incenses that Aurashikha has, and I got this incense from there. The incenses there are at a very high discount, anywhere from 10% to, you know, 60%, 50-60%, and you get good incense materials, you get cones, you get incenses, you get sandalwood powder, you get different resins, and there is a whole lot of things. You have essential oils, you have different kind of diffusers, gift boxes, soaps, so many other things, and a wide variety of incenses, because Aurashikha Agarbatti is it's popular world over, and that's the reason that it caters to very many people, you know, world over, and they have a whole lot of fragrances that you don't get in India, and that is not as much, you know, as favorite in India as in other parts of the world. So you get very many fragrances, very different kind of fragrances, and it's a whole lot of a huge range, you know. And you might, if you're here in Delhi or in Gurgaon or anywhere near Delhi, or if you are anywhere where you have an Aurobindo Ashram, you might just want to go and check out the Shabda bookstore there, and they have a wide variety of incenses and incense materials, and very good quality ones, so you might just want to check out those. In fact, people who run incense stores buy from there, and then they, you know, sell the incenses at MRP in their own store. So this is the kind of store that is there. If you are unable to visit the store, you can just call them up, and I'll be giving the link in the, I'll be giving the number in the description. And there's an app called Dunzo. So you can install that app, and these people will pick up the incenses from Aurashikha, Aurobindo Ashram, and they'll deliver it to you, and you can pay them by Paytm. So that also can be done. But if you've never been to Aurobindo Ashram, and if you've never seen the incense range, and if you are an incense enthusiast, I'd request you to just go there and, you know, just spend a nice time, just take a little time and go there and just enjoy yourself. If you are an incense enthusiast, it's your if you are an incense enthusiast, it's going to be a pilgrimage. So just consider it that way and just visit the Aurobindo Ashram Shabda store once and check out the incense range. Now, so what we have inside here is 10 grams of incense we have in this, and it's a regular sized black incense, and the bamboo core is it's strong and sturdy, and it's beige in color, just like that. And it's a regular sized average agarbatti, if you see that. The fragrance is nice and strong and sweet and very, very Rajnigandha. If you like the Rajnigandha fragrance, I would really suggest you just try this once. So that's the cold incense. It's a nice strong fragrance of Rajnigandha, and let's just check out the incense smoke as such. Let's light up the incense and check out the fragrance of it. It's an amazing fragrance, guys. You know, if you like the Rajnigandha fragrance, you know, the kind of fragrance, like if you walk into a banquet hall which is decorated with Rajnigandha, or if you've been to a marriage pandal or a marriage party or somewhere where the entire place has Rajnigandha all over, the kind of fragrance that you get there is what you're getting here. The siyaz of this fragrance is nice. It spreads to a large area, and you will have neighbors coming over and asking which is the fragrance that you want, and that's the kind of fragrance you have. If you are well versed with the Rajnigandha fragrance, and if this is burning somewhere, you will know instantly that this is the Rajnigandha fragrance. And like all other Aurobindo incenses, this also has a nice sweet base which is sweet and strong. So, and it is very, very Bengali. And if you are a Bengali, or if you've been in Bengal, if you've been to any of those Bengali ashrams, you know, like my house is near RK Mission, and we often visit that place, and I get this fragrance. This is a typical Bengali fragrance that I get from there. And so if you like that kind of fragrance, which is like strong and sweet, and that floral, that strong Rajnigandha fragrance, then you like this. And if you do not like strong fragrances, I'd suggest you stay away from this, because this is a nice strong fragrance. And like that Mukhalla thing which was so strong I could not sleep the whole night. This is a kind of fragrance, if you like it, it's going to stay there. It'll linger a long time, you know. So if you like that kind of fragrance, you like it. And if you don't like strong fragrance, if you don't like strong sweet floral fragrance, stay away from this. For that matter, I've noticed that all of the marbled incenses of Aurashikha, which comes in packs like these, have this kind of common base which is strong and sweet and very Bengali. So if you like that Bengali kind of fragrance, you will like this. If not, I'd suggest you stay away from this. So this is entirely it's like a nice Bengali fragrance. So this is exactly for people who are looking for nice strong floral fragrance, and one of my favorite fragrances. I did try Rajnigandha once. I tried phool, and somehow like other phool fragrances, I did not like it that much, because that annoying base in that phool fragrance was also there. So I don't like that kind of it has something which is like, I really don't like. It's like Maggi, you know, no matter what you add to Maggi, no matter how much, you know, how well you make it, no matter what you add to it, it's still that Maggi, you know, that Maggi taste. I hate it. So it's the same with phool. I'm sorry, I don't mean to be rude. I don't mean to, hurt you in any way, but I did not like that Rajnigandha fragrance. I like this because I like this kind of fragrance. I specifically like Bengali fragrance, and I like this sweet, strong, floral kind of fragrance. So if you like Rajnigandha fragrance, you will like this. So this is Aurashikha Agarbatti's Rajnigandha Tube Rose Incense. So this is what you have. Wow. 10 grams of incense for 38 rupees, which I think I must have got for around 28 or 30, something like that. So this is what we have. And I just came across an interesting fact about the Rajnigandha incense, the Rajnigandha fragrance, or the energetics that it brings about, you know. So it says that Rajnigandha helps you, you know, it helps you get a proper personal guard to yourself. So, you know, it helps you evolve your character within you, but it helps you, it protects yourself, you know. So you are not influenced by what, you know, whatever the whatever lies outside of it. And there's a strong guard, you know, around your personal zone. That's the kind of energetics that Tuberose has. And I just found it very interesting. I thought might as well share it with you guys. So that's the one thing I wanted you to know. In the last quiz, I'd asked you what is the where is the manufacturing unit of Aurashikha incenses located, and the answer is Pondicherry. They have this address here. It says Aurashikha Garbatis, Sri Aurobindo Ashram, Pondicherry, 605002, India, and then they have aurashikha.com. So that is there. And once again, if you are here somewhere in Delhi, or you know, anywhere, if you have that Aurobindo Ashram, please go and check out the incenses there. So now the quiz for today is, name the resin that we get from the peepal tree. So the peepal tree gives out a resin from which we get a very nice incense. Just name that resin. And that's all for the episode today. I hope you enjoyed the episode and you learned something from it. If you think somebody else can learn something from it too, share it with them. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Check out the description for the link of this incense and very many other incense products, incense related products, and the book Meri Pratham Sanskrit Pustika, which is a Sanskrit alphabet book for kids. So check out the description box and do try to answer the quiz. Until we meet again next, take very good care of yourself. Namaste.